What up, gamers? T.U.G here. This is episode 81 of the Ultimate Let's Play Pokemon Heart Gold. We have finally made it to Cinnabar Island, and I can finally heal up. We're going to go ahead and do that first. And apparently, since the red and blue days, the volcano has erupted on Cinnabar. And pretty much everything except the Pokemon Center has been wiped out. It's now just a bunch of rocky mountains. Also, the gym that used to be here got wiped out. It has been relocated to the Seafoam Islands. We're going to be heading there next. See a few places where we need rock climb. And here is Blue. He is the Viridian Sea gym leader and former Pokemon League champion. So yeah, we need to beat the next gym before we are going to be able to challenge Blue at the Viridian Gym. Yeah, there's going to be a lot of items up there, but I need Rock Climb to get it. So I'm just going to go ahead, burn a Max Repel. That's really all we can do here at Cinnabar at the moment. So we're going to continue our trek. We are now going to be heading east to the Seafoam Islands. And another sea route means even more trainers. We're going to start with this guy here. Alright, let's get it on. He's going to start off with a Wingull, a member of the Hoenn generation. It's water flying, one EV point in speed. However, that typing gives it a double weakness to electricity. As you see right here, this is going to be a one-hit knockout, I guarantee it. There you go. And now we got Fearow, another Pokemon we're familiar with. But I'm going to let Typhlosion take this one. Again, being on a water route, Typhlosion's not going to get a lot of opportunities to build levels. I think he's only a level or two away from learning Eruption. Okay, one Flamethrower was enough to take down Fearow. So now let's head back into the water, start dealing with some of the trainers in the blue. Okay, this guy's got just one Pokemon, it's Azumarill. They have a resilient water Pokemon, 3 EV points in HP. Let's see if it can handle my discharge though. Nope. Gotta keep an eye out for hidden items. I know there's gonna be a few on the dry parts of the route. I believe this is a new Pokemon we have not seen before. This is Love Disc, straight up water type, 1 EV point in speed. Never really used it in battle. Honestly, in my opinion, not really that good. Doesn't evolve. And, yeah, I really got nothing else on this guy. Trying to spread the experience points around. It's very easy to mistake this Pokemon for a rock type, but it's not, so my fighting moves are just going to do normal damage. Well, unless you count stab, which is same type attack bonus. Basically, if you're using an attack that's the same type as your Pokemon, it does time and a half the damage. So close combat, I believe, has base power of 120. With Heracross, it's going to be 180. You know, things like that. And Heracross is going to get to level 53 now. Still waiting on that Mega Horn. Okay, moving on here. My dad's machine's picking up something right here. Got more Stardust. Looks like just these two trainers left, I think. Yeah, luckily this is a short route. Okay, one Pokemon. This is Shinx, who came to us in the Sinnoh region. Shinx is an electric type, much like Ampharos, 1 EV point attack. I'm going to let Typhlosion take this one. I think that was just charge 2. And Shinx will eventually evolve into Luxio and then Luxray. Basically, if you ask me, Sinnoh's equivalent of the Mareep evolution. Though I think Shinx is a lot quicker. Maybe even compare it to Electrike in the Hoenn region, even though that only has 2 evolutionary levels. Yes, I will battle you, and I will beat you. Starly. Another Sinnoh Pokemon, if I'm not mistaken. Basically, Sinnoh's version of Pidgey. 1 EV point in speed. Will evolve into Staravia, and eventually Staraptor. Well, we're seeing some new Pokemon, albeit Wink ones. Alright. Well, the path is starting to narrow a bit, so we are getting very close to the Seafoam Islands. Let's check it for any items I may have missed. Looks like there's one on the other side of that. I'm probably going to have to pass through Seafoam Islands to get there. And now we got a Bidoof. We got another Sinnoh Pokemon. Basically, Sinnoh's version of Rattata. This guy has 1 EV point HP. Though when it evolves, it becomes a normal water type, which I believe is the only instance of that typing. I think. Well, anyway, Focus Blast took it down. And there's the entrance to Seafoam. Looks like I'm gonna have one more trainer to deal with before I can go in there. Now, I should now call it the Seafoam Gym. Yep. Cinnabar Gym is now the Seafoam Gym, but the leader's the same, Blaine. He specializes in fire types. First, we're gonna take this guy out, and Shroomish. Shroomish, a member of the Hoenn region. It is a grass type, 180 point in HP. Will eventually evolve into Breloom, who becomes a grass fighting type. Is that going to be enough for a level up? Nah. But then again, it is a first level evolution. I'm just curious to see if there are maybe any hidden items over there. I'm gonna go ahead and heal up real quick. This is going to be the gym where Gyarados just thrives. Now, I believe in the original Gold and Silver, all that was here was the gym. Here you go upstairs to get there. I believe downstairs, though, is the actual Seafoam Island. So we'll have to go through here, it looks like, to get to the next area. So, I'm going to call it quits here. I know it's going to be a short episode. Next episode, we'll take on the Seafoam Gym. And, we'll see what happens during that time. So until then, I'm T.U.G. Later, gamers.